Now let's give the crocodile a grain shading texture. Some of the techniques uses will be explained more in depth in later lectures. To shade the body, I will first combine the body parts. I right click on the body and choose select same fill color. Then I go to path union. I call the united path body parts. I will drag the body parts path out of the feet group above the feet. I right click on the body parts path and choose set clip group. I name the clip group body shading. You can recognize a clip group by a folder with a scissors sign. When I open the body shading folder, I see a folder called clip. Whatever is in this folder will be used as a clipping mask. I want to reuse the body parts path, so I press Ctrl D. I drag the copy outside the clip folder. And I duplicate it again. With the rectangle tool, I draw a rectangle that is larger than the body parts. I drag body parts above the rectangle. Then I press Ctrl 9 three times. What I did is inset the path with three steps. I hold shift and also select the rectangle. I go to path, difference. I call the result, texture. I close and open layer 2 to get more room and open body shading again. I drag the fill and stroke panel all the way to the bottom until I see a blue blinking rectangle. Then I let go of the mouse. I click on texture. At the bottom of fill and stroke, I increase blur to about 30. I click on the black swatch. I go to filters, overlays, noise fill. I click on the noise color tab and set alpha to 0. Then I click on options. I click on live preview. For turbulence type, I choose fractal noise. With horizontal and vertical frequency, you can make the grain smaller and larger. I click on apply. At some parts, I want more grain, and at some parts less. To do this, I click on the node tool. Right now there are 32 nodes I can drag, which I find too many. So I go to path, simplify. Now I have 18 nodes, which is better. I also lower the opacity of the texture. I will set it to 25%. Now I will adjust the visibility of the grain by dragging the nodes.